how sleep helps process your emotions. Some people have faced events that left them traumatized and scarred for life, but the brain has a way to cope, even though it can take time to fully recover. According to new research, very specific mechanisms happen when the brain triages emotions during dream sleep. This may explain some mental health conditions. Humans need to sleep like most animals out there. As day creatures, we sleep better at night. If you sleep during the day, you need to create the dark setting to reach some sleep. This is because light, artificial or natural, wakes up the brain. In sleep medicine, there's a sleep state that remains mysterious to experts. It is called REM or rapid eye movement, known for its unique characteristic where dreams occur along with intense emotions. So when you enter REM, your dream will likely be accompanied by powerful emotions, giving that vivid experience. At the University of Bern, how and why these emotions get reactivated is unclear. So, researchers investigated possible mechanisms and published their findings in the journal Science. The team revealed that the brain's prefrontal cortex integrates many emotions when we are awake, yet rarely sets them in dormant mode during sleep. But in some, that duality fades later on because of an event or due to a biological issue. Another point researchers revealed is the processing of emotions. The brain does it to distinguish danger from safety. When you experience too many negative emotions for a long time, your risk of anxiety, depression, PTSD, and other mental health problems rises exponentially. When the brain processes them, anxiety and fear reactions become dominant because it sees more danger flags, triggering a fight or flight response. In their study, researchers conditioned one set of mice to detect audio stimuli of safety while another set with audio stimuli of danger. Then, the sleep-wake cycles of the mice's brains were recorded to let the team map various areas of a cell. Results showed that the bodies of neurons or soma were silent, while their dendrites or input were active. Those were opposite, where soma should be active and dendrites silent during wakefulness, highlighting a decoupling of two cellular parts. Here, the decoupling was translated as the brain favoring the discrimination of safety versus danger during input, but stops the overreaction to emotions strongly linked to danger. The favoring means survival instinct kicking in during dangerous situations. However, if the mechanisms have been altered or damaged for some reason, it would explain what might be happening in PTSD. The prefrontal cortex might be drowning from too much stress or negative emotions, risking the chance of fear reactions. This decoupling might be behind many mental health conditions, including the inability to feel pleasure. Hopefully, this could lead to something tangible in the real world that would aid sufferers of anxiety, depression, panic, and PTSD. Do you remember having night terrors? How vivid were they? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.